Star Wars is a franchise that I've grown to love ever since I was young. It is a series that I've realized will not please everyone. People tend to think that the original trilogy was amazing, the prequel trilogy was mediocre, and the sequel trilogy was downright awful and for justifiable reasons. In this video, I'm only going to focus on the latest installment in the saga, The Rise of Skywalker, and explain why I hate it. I'm going to break this video down into three parts: story, characters, and how it concludes the Skywalker saga. The Rise of Skywalker takes place approximately a year after The Last Jedi, and Rey has had some time to train with the help of Leia. Between the two movies, Palpatine sent out a message to everyone in the galaxy stating that he wasn't dead despite the events in Return of the Jedi. For the last 30 years, he has been manufacturing a fleet of Star Destroyers with essentially Death Stars equipped to every one of them. As you expect, it is up to Rey, Finn, Poe, and a few droids to rid the galaxy of evil. To sum up the rest of the plot, Chewie dies and comes back, C-3PO dies, comes back, Leia dies and doesn't come back, Han comes back, but as Kylo's mental illness, Kylo dies on the inside, comes to the light side in 2 minutes, then dies again. You think Rose died because she's never there. Hux died for good. Palpatine died for good again. Rey dies in comeback, but not just as Rey, but as Rey Skywalker. And boom, the galaxy has been saved once again. If you think that was too bland or broad, then you're not mistaken. But at the same time, I'm not exaggerating. The story is literally that. Many areas, the story does not put the previous movies into consideration. This includes sequels, prequels, and original trilogy. The Rise of Skywalker seems most disconnected from the rest of the saga. It makes one reference, maybe two references to The Last Jedi in the entire movie, and that is all about the recognition the previous movies received in the conclusion to the saga. This film feels like a horrible fan film, and just because it has a few lightsabers in it, it earns the title of Star Wars. It's obvious that the movie we got was such a shell of the movie we could have got. Throughout this movie, it's obvious through storytelling elements that this film was Frankenstein together, and I think that was the biggest issue with this trilogy as a whole. There was no definitive beginning, middle, and end. Everything was thought of during the making of these films. I'd imagine a crew member walking up to the director in the middle of a take and saying, "I just got an idea." And without thinking about how it'll correlate with the rest of the narrative, the director's like, "Let's add it." This is what The Rise of Skywalker feels like, and considering Disney had since 2014 to write even a super, super rough draft of this story and did it, is why this movie failed. If there is one movie I can draw many connections to, it is Avengers Endgame. Now tell me why The Rise of Skywalker has full scenes from Avengers Endgame.
More of us, Poe. There are more of us.
I am all the Sith.
And I...
the Jedi.
Just the inclusion of those two sequences is downright pathetic. It shows the lack of care or creative freedom. It shows that nothing was planned from the beginning and the film was shoehorned together due to the success of a previous Disney film. And it shows that this franchise is ultimately doomed if Disney doesn't bring back what made Star Wars great: the love, passion, and dedication. Not a way to make $1 billion from one movie. I remember watching the old films and feeling the same feelings that the characters felt: hope. But now as I walk away and reflect on the ending of the saga, the only thing I feel is disgust. The characters are some of the most memorable parts of cinema as a whole. No matter who you talk to, everyone knows who Darth Vader or Obi-Wan Kenobi are.
Hello there.
These are names one can easily associate with the franchise without being a Star Wars fan. The characters in this new trilogy of movies were weak and underdeveloped. Similar to the original trilogy, these movies brought us a new trio of galactic heroes: Finn, Poe, and Rey. These characters easily mirror Leia, Han, and Luke. However, Finn, Poe, and Rey do not stand out like the original trilogy characters. They will be memorable because of what they were a part of, but they will not be remembered for being great or, in some cases, even good. Finn was a defector, and that is cool. Finn had feelings for Rey, as shown in The Force Awakens, and vaguely in The Rise of Skywalker, but Rose had feelings for Finn as shown in The Last Jedi. Not once is this love triangle even mentioned in The Rise of Skywalker. Rose had less than 2 minutes of screen time, and the interaction of Finn and Rey was minimal. Finn's love life will forever be an unsolved mystery due to poor character development. That is a common trend throughout this trilogy, poor character development. Poe makes many mistakes as far as taking things into his own hands when he shouldn't. You would expect by the third movie, his story arc will come in a complete circle and he will realize the importance of patience and leadership. But as expected, he doesn't. He learns absolutely nothing. However, in a brief scene, we learn that he was a spice runner. Some information that would make this movie so much worse if we were not in the film. Rey is a Mary Sue of the trilogy. She has little to no training and is able to best Kylo Ren. By the second movie, she is considered a Jedi all because she was able to hit a rock. In this movie, it is believed that Leia has been training her for about a year, and after a year of vigorous Jedi training, she still can't complete a simple obstacle course. She is being trained by someone who never even finished their own training, yet she is probably more powerful than Luke. Someone who's trained by a Jedi Master, someone who trained for years between The Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi, and someone who didn't best their enemy on their first try. Rey's story was mediocre and barely touched. The most intriguing part of her story was her family and the fact that she came from nothing, but in good old Disney fashion, the movie decides to bring a character back with no buildup or reason and claim Palpatine as her grandfather. Real original Disney. Kylo Ren is easily the best character of the trilogy, but as I've said to a few people, it's like mud pie and mud cake. You're always going to get mud. Kylo Ren is the best of the worst. What made his character great in The Force Awakens and The Last Jedi was only shown in for the first 2 minutes of The Rise of Skywalker. The genuine rage and fire in him, the fact that he was fierce and vicious and believed that nothing was standing in his way, was missing for the majority of the film. Kylo Ren's story arc was a complete turnaround, which would have been great if executed better. Him turning into a good guy was a way for Disney to say, there's a good person in all of us. Which, sure, I guess, but there is nothing hinting at the fact that Kylo was a good guy in the last two movies. He was selfish, fearless, and unstable. Nothing more. You can't possibly tell me someone like that will immediately fight for the right thing just because Han, who he killed, decided right now was the time to give him PTSD. I didn't mind his change of heart, but I wish it had more substance and meaning. Palpatine was not built up at all and should have been included in the film. To label this as a conclusion to the saga is downright pathetic and disrespectful to anyone who loves Star Wars. I found that those who do like this movie have conformed with the fact that these new movies will never be as good as the originals, but that is no reason to love trash. This is the final chapter to a story spanning across 40 years, and this is the best that they could do? It's truly sad, and the name Star Wars will forever be tarnished because of what the goals of the executives were, to make money. If you ever watched the podcast, you probably have briefly heard us talk about Star Wars and The Rise of Skywalker, and I thought I'd make a video as to why I have the feelings for the movie, because I don't like just saying I don't like something and then not, you know, give my reason for it. So, I mean, let me know in the comments what you think about The Rise of Skywalker. Let me know if you enjoyed it, if you didn't like it, let me know why. I'm open to have an awesome conversation with you guys, and that's what makes movies, in my opinion, just so awesome. It's up to interpretation. It's how we want to perceive it. The reason why I liked it or didn't like it is completely different from the reason why you may have liked it or didn't like it, and that's what's awesome about films and this channel. But yeah, I appreciate all you guys for coming out and watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please be sure to leave a like rating. Please continue to share the channel. You guys are awesome. We are pushing 100 subscribers, and we're just really excited about the future of this channel. Follow us on Twitter at @OfficialPopCult. If you're on PlayStation, join our PlayStation community, Pop Culture Today, as well as join our Discord server, where we will be communicating with you guys better about our community nights and other events that may be happening on the channel. As always, guys, have a wonderful day, and peace out.